Hello, I'm being frank with you. Sunday morning, I've had to do the Mercy Dash to the local shops to get a pizza. And I'm in the car park and here people are all gearing up to go on their bicycle trips through the countryside. So I wonder how many walkers and bicycles I will get down my track today. I don't think I'll be keeping count. I'm not really that interested. But it's a nice day. I thought about doing the garden. I've got the petrol for the garden grass cutter, but it's raining overnight, just a little bit of raining, but enough to make it all wet. So maybe need to wait till later in the day before I start cutting. I'm sure I'll find other things to do. I'm having a bit of a rest. I've been fighting with our bonfire, trying to get rid of all the rubbish that the gardener moved from one part of the garden to the other. I just said to my wife, you know, gardening is not making one bit pretty by dumping everything somewhere else. I suppose I'm particularly annoyed because I nearly lost my left arm. I got it trapped underneath some heavy wood that I was moving onto the fire. And it got kind of hot. I'll show you my arm. It's not pretty. Most of the damage was done on my arm by trying to pull it back out from underneath these logs before the flames. It was a choice, you know, rip the skin on your arm or get burnt. So I chose the ripping of the skin. It sounded like it would be less painful. Not so sure now. Anyway, my wife's going to spray it with something which will help it heal, and then we'll go back to work. Grass is still a bit damp, but I'm still hopeful that I can get the grass cutter out and do some. Just started to bring the grass down to a manageable level. But there's a lot of it. And I still have to find out if the grass cutter is going to start. This will be the first time since it went to sleep for the winter. But for now, I'm just going to sit back, relax, have my coffee, and chill as best I can. So, the tadpole project's week number, I don't know anymore. Probably five. They're getting bigger. I've already taken water from the tank. I'm going to put the other water, the new water, into the tank. This water comes from the pond. I've taken some of the pond wheat because it looks like maybe they've eaten the old stuff. So I'm hoping that, let's make this a bit quicker. So, they seem to get used to the water change. They don't go completely frantic. Maybe a bit sleepy, who knows? But at least, after this time, all nine are still alive and I don't suppose kicking is the right word because they don't have any legs yet. This is our ride-on mower. We got it with the house, so it must be about 14 years old anyway. It's very unpredictable, temperamental. In other words, most of the times it does not start. Last year, at the end of the summer, we had it serviced, and I'm hopeful now that the battery has been on charge for a day, and I've got some petrol, so let's just see if we can get it going. That's the battery installed. Just need to top up with some petrol and turn the key and see if it starts. Fingers crossed. It's struggling to start, so I'm going to try by putting a little bit of fuel direct into the carburetor and see if that will make it start. It's not working out to be a great day with the tractor.
Attempts earlier on with trying to put a small amount of petrol straight into the carburetor have not worked because I think the battery is now so low. So I've now had lunch and the battery's been on charge for about 2 hours. So let's see if there's enough charge in it now. We'll do a little bit of the trick with the petrol in the carburetor and see if we can get the thing just to start up. It really is a bit wearing. You know, about a year ago, I had someone look at it and I said to my wife, "What did the guy get, what did he do to it when he took it away?" It turns out all he did was change the belts. I think this is maybe the third person I've had look at the tractor, and I've said, "All I want you to do is make it start." And everybody else finds something else to do. They unchange the belts, or they wash and polish it. I don't know what they do, but they're not actually repairing a problem that exists with it, and I don't know how to fix it. I'm not an engine sort of person. Anyway, rant over. Let's try the recharge battery. Probably seems a bit cruel, but I want to move into a place where the tractor has not been, sorry, which has been cut. He's cute. He's probably terrified. Yeah, I don't think he's suffered from his capture. He's okay. Every year the tractor gives me a hard time, but eventually it starts and then I can go and cut grass. Actually, it went quite well. It took me a couple of hours, but it got all the grass cut, or as much as I could reach. It seems that the accesses to the front of the house, I can't get through, some blocked with pieces of masonry, others with scaffolding, so that will have to wait. Probably not such a big deal. So that's the end of the weekend. Although it's a bank holiday here in the UK, I'm not going to take the bank holiday. I need to do some work before I go on my own holiday at the end of next week. So I'll be going to work tomorrow. It should be an easy ride to work because bank holiday, usually very little traffic on the road. I hope you've had a good weekend and I hope you have a nice weekend with the bank holiday. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss.